Well, hello, my YouTube fans and Magic the Gathering players. So, I decided to go with another Magic the Gathering video before the chess video. As you can see, I've got my bundle pack ready to open. So, when I got the pre-release kit, I noticed right away, and I think I mentioned in my video, that there seems to be a whole new set of artwork and some artists that I think I recognize some of their names, and it's not just the lands that look cool, it's throughout the deck. So since I couldn't sit there and memorize all the artists' names throughout, you know, looking through the cards, I decided to write down the ones for the lands, and we're gonna open up the lands pack in this and take a look at some of the artwork we like or don't like or we think is really cool or whatever. Okay, so let me I don't know, for some reason it doesn't look focused to me. Let me get that straight right away. I think that's about it. All right, so let's go ahead and open up the box. The first bundle pack of Dominaria opened up on my channel. Here we go. Trust the old knife. Let's hope for a green die, you know, countdown die this time. I like the green ones. I'm just strange like that. Alright, so let's go ahead and toss that. Let's go ahead and remove the box of nothing. And of course there's the security tag and the player's guide. Yes, the good old player's guide. All the list of cards in it. One of these days I'm going to use these guides to look through my cards and see what I do or don't have. As you can see, they list all the cards. Of course, with my eyesight, you know, I'd have to find a way to magnify this. Maybe I can hold it up to the camera or something and flip through and look at the screen. I don't know. But in any case, there it is, the player's guide. And let's take a look at the art on the so-called poster that the actual sleeve is. Okay, we're going to carefully try not to bend. Pull that rubbery glue off there. I call it snot glue. Oops, I think I just bent it. Okay. It's okay. I'm not crazy about this particular work of art. It's alright. So that's the Dominaria poster. Let's just go ahead and, well, let's go ahead and pull that snot glue off. Twang. Look at that, the way it comes off. Boink. Okay. Let's throw the snot in the garbage. Stuck to my fingers and didn't go quite in. Alright. Let's put that back there. And here we go. So, what do we got? Well, it's blue, not green. It's not bad though. It's a good blue. It's got like speckles on it or something like that. Okay. Let's go ahead and drop that in the box. So we got 10 packs, of course. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And the land pack. So I think I want to do something different this time. I'm going to open up the land pack because I really like this art. As you can see, it's another one that I don't have out of the other six packs. Like, oh, well, let me put this knife away, by the way, so I don't lean on it and cut my arm get a magnifying glass so that I can actually read the names. Here we go. Trusty little magnifying glass. So, yes, Dmitar Marinsky. I did write that one down. And he also does a mountain, so he does plains too, apparently. So let's go ahead and open these guys up and see if we can spot all the names. What is this, a 50 pack, 80 pack, 60 pack? What is this? 80. So I got 80 land cards. So I deliberately bought, I wasn't going to buy, you know, because it costs a bit, you know, it's kind of frivolous for me to be spending money on this. I wasn't going to buy the bundle pack. I was just going to buy something less, you know, like maybe six packs or something like that to open up for you guys. But when I started to see the artwork, you know, I'm into the seeing the artwork, I figured I'd need the pack with the lands in it. Because everything else doesn't come with lands, and they don't have the deck builder's toolkit on this set either, which I would have gotten instead just for the fact that it has the lands. So there you have it, this story. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at the what I say, this was Dmitar Marinsky, I believe. Yeah, so let's go ahead and see if we can get the camera to focus on that. That's a good job, camera, good job. If I could just hold it steady enough. See, I really think it's, you know, like detailed artwork. I think it's interesting. Oh, I'm talking away from the microphone. That says I'm looking at the screen. Okay. And on this island, we have Jonas DeRoe. Jonas DeRoe does a plains as well, and he does a swamp as well. So it looks like, so far, just by looking at two cards and the ones that I had from the other pre-release kit, it looks like they all have a hand in doing each land. Pretty cool. I really think that's, I mean, look at the waves in the ocean. I mean, I think that's a pretty good detail. There's like some kind of castle in the back. Interesting artwork. Interesting. And we have Mark Poole. Also does an island. So, like, again, it's showing me that this is a swamp. So it's showing me that they all seem to be doing a land each. You know, like all the lands. We'll find out how many are. Usually there's four. Like four of every color. So maybe they all have, maybe there's four artists and they all have a color of their own. Okay, so that's swamp. And so the way they're sorting out these cards is they're not sorting them all, they're just putting one after the other color. Another Mark Poole. Okay, so I have this. No, I don't have this one. I do now. This is another Mark Poole. Actually, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to put the artists together. You know, the artwork of each artist. That's a good idea. This is all right. It's kind of strange. It's not overwhelming. So that goes on top of the Mark Poole art. Titus Lunter. I do have this one in the. You know, the artwork in this set is really interesting. Do I have a Titus Lunter? No. Okay. And this one is Titus Lunter again. Well, it looks like they're sorting them almost by artist here. This is a Plains by Titus Lunter. And I don't want to jinx myself, but I'm going to thank the camera for actually focusing. And it's Titus Lunter is his name. Okay, so Titus Lunter goes with Titus Lunter. I do have this one. This is Mark Poole. Okay, it comes with Mark Poole. Yeah, so it looks like they all have, all the artists seem to have every color, I think. Let me see, so far I only got four here. So what am I missing? I got Plains, Island. No, I got five. I got five here. Plains, Island, Forest. Okay, so there seems to be four artists so far. Let me see. I do have this one. This is Jonas Durow. And it's a swamp. So it's Jonas's swamp. I like the Jonas Durow. Okay, focus. There we go. I do like this one. Let's see if I can get it even closer. Look at that volcano or whatever that is in the background. No, it's not a volcano. That's something else. I don't think it'll focus this close. Oh, yes, it will. That's some kind of magic energy or something. I don't know what that is. But, yeah, pretty good, pretty good. That's the Jonas pile. Once I reach a certain point where I get all the artists, and you know, I'm not going to go through the entire deck. I'm just going to, you know, get all the works of art, you know, so that I can see all the artists in the lands. Dimitar. I thought it was Dimitri when I first read it. It was Dimitar Mirinsky. And that pile is all the way on the right. Okay, so he did a mountain, or it could be a woman. I don't know. I don't know these names. I'm not crazy about that one. All right. Okay, here's a nice one, I think. It's Durow. Yep, Jonas Durow again. In a forest. Another forest. No, that's not him. Where's Jonas Durow? Okay. No, okay, so he does. This is his forest. I'm pretty sure Jonas is a man's name. Nice, huh? Nice? What do you think? Not bad? And there's his name. Why is that not focused there? It was focused the other way. I just decided to unfocus. Oh, here we go. There we go. Jonas Durow. Okay, there we go. And that's that one. All right, so far I've got three and three and two and two. So let's see. So there seems to be four artists so far for the lands. Oh, this is an interesting one. This is Mark Poole's Plains. That's nice. I like this one. Not bad. So that's his Plains. Where's Mark Poole's pile? That's right there. So that's Mark Poole's plane. His island, his mountain, and his swamp. So we need one more color. We need a forest for him. This is Titus Lunter's island. Very nice. I like that one too. Yeah. So this is it's interesting to me to see all the new art, and you're going to see the art in the playing, you know, cards as well, the creatures and whatnot. A lot of them are much more I don't know what word I'm going to use here. They're just more realistic, some of them, not all of them, but some of them. And I said that was Jonas Lunter. And he is here. So that's three for him. Mitar Marinsky. Marinsky again. Let's take a look at that one. And that's a swamp. That's one we haven't seen yet. See, I like this one too. You know, you can get these works of art. You know, I don't know how much they cost, but you can get these works of art. You can buy them, prints. It probably costs a small fortune, but if I was really that interested in hanging a few of these works of art in the house, I have to come up with several hundred dollars, I'm sure. Okay, so that was Dimitar. Where is he? Or she, I'm not sure which. Okay, that's three for that artist. And there's a mountain I haven't seen yet by Jonas Durow. I like this one too. It looks like a real mountain, you know, walking path through a mountain. Interesting. Okay. Where's Jonas's pile? Here he is. So that's four for him. It's island, swamp, forest, and mountain. And another one. So far, I'm getting all strangers. I don't see any repeats yet. Here's Mark Poole, forest. Look at that. There's a face in there. Now that is some cool artwork. Again, I'm talking away from the microphone. I'm sorry. That is definitely some cool artwork. Look at that face in the. That's some pretty cool artwork. Yes. So that's Mark Poole's forest, and find his pile here. So that's all five for him. Okay. So I don't think there's going to be any others. There's the five colors. This is Mark Poole's pile. I'm not crazy about his island, but I do like the rest of them. I especially like his forest. So that's Mark Poole's pile of five. Okay, who is this? This one is Jonas Durow. It's his planes. Very realistic looking, I think. Okay. And Jonas Durow is here, and that's his five. Let's move these packs. Yeah, I definitely, you know, unfortunately, I don't think there's any full arts in these, you know, like they used to give you with the... And I used to collect those, and of course the John Avon full art borderless from the Unstable pack. Of course, I collected those. I'm still waiting to see if I can pick up a pack every now and again and perhaps get a foil of those arts. But so far I haven't hit one. Okay, so that's two of the artists. That's Mark Poole and Jonas Durow. I believe that there shouldn't be any more for them other than repeats. So let's see who this is, because this is different. Nice. Very nice. It's kind of a dark island, though, isn't it? Who is this? This is Dimitar Marinsky's. Okay, that's four for that person. Again, I don't know if that's a male's name or a female's name. So for now, we'll just call it the artist. And Titus Lunter's swamp. Not bad, not bad. Okay, where's Titus's pile? That's this one. He's got four now. Okay. We should be finding the other two, and I do see the repeating after these two cards. So Titus Lunter again, his mountain. Titus, yeah, I guess that's a man's name. Okay. And that'll be his five. There goes the poster on the floor. That's all right. And finally, Dimitar Maritsky, the unknown male or female name. Dimitar. Like Dimitri would be a guy's name. But Dimitar, I don't know. Could be either, I suppose. It's not bad. And that's those five. So, obviously there are four artists doing the lands. And each of them have all five colors. And but the reason why I'm saying that is because now this is back to you know, it's a copy of the first one of Dimitar's, and this is a copy of DeRoe's Island. Okay, so it's all repeating now. So apparently they just the way they sorted these, they sorted them by every color and then every artist in conjunction. So we don't have to, obviously we don't have to look at the rest of the deck because there are, oh, wait, let's make sure. I'm not sure if I remember. Oh yeah, there it is. Okay, yeah. Oh yeah, this one's printed different. It's darker or something. Well, anyways, we don't have to look at the rest of the deck because they're repeats of what you see there. So that was an interesting start for my trying to get an artist video going, which I've never done. I keep promising you and I never do it, but at least that's a start. We're just going to put these on top of each other like this and put the lands over there out of scene, almost out of scene, and let's get to the packs. Let's also put this box like this so we can put the cards in them. This is the reference guide, whatever. Oh, excuse me. Alright. Pack number one. Okay. Of course, I was told, by the way, somebody made a comment that I should know this set better. That is, I'm missing the fact that I think each pack has at least one legendary creature. He might have said two, and I think if there was two, it took place of the rare or something like that. I think that's what he said. So that's different about these packs. This set, I should say. All right, let me see if I can find a place to throw garbage without going all over the place. Okay, so let's turn this right side up. All right, Warlord's Fury. Okay, one, two. I'm going to stop at any interesting art that I like, to, you know, specifically. One, two, three, four. Oh, that's interesting already. Artist is Elias Lashido. Okay. So one, two, three, four, five. It's all interesting. I can't stop for every card. Six. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Jousting. Elena Danner. Focus. Nice. Seven. Oh man, I'm not going to stop at every card, but I can't resist in the beginning of this. Like I said, the artwork in this set is definitely more intriguing. It's just nice. Let me see. This one is Christine Choi. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. Seismic Shift is the tenth. That's an interesting piece of art. Not that interesting, but the artist is James Paik. Oh, James Paik. I wrote that one down because he does, you know, the special lands, you know, the the land come, you know, goes on to the battlefield tapped, that sort of thing. Memorial to Genius is James Pake. And Richard Wright did a memorial to war. So they're naming these special lands now memorial to something. And that was a red one. The war was a red one. The genius is blue. And that was James Pake that did the blue one. So that's interesting. Richard Wright did the other one. So if I spot any of those. Okay, so anyway, these are the uncommons. One, two, and it looks like I have two uncommons in a rare. I think they sorted these different this time. I think there's another uncommon underneath it is. Okay, all is interesting artwork, but I can't go through every pack with all the interesting artwork and all that because it'll take all night long to do this. Yeah, okay, so there's my rare. It's if I can get it to focus. Focus. Any day now. It's going to start messing up on me. Well, if this video wasn't going to take long already for me looking at all the artists, it's going to take me a lot longer now if it's going to start not focusing. All right, come on. There we go. So, Mishra's self-replicator is the rare. Okay, artifact creature, assembly worker. If those are the commons, then these are the rares. And there's another uncommon, like I suspected. Okay, well, if it's not going to focus, I'm not going to. The video is taking too long already. There's my uncommons, there's my rares. And we've got Jonas de Rose Island and an emblem token. Okay, so let's go ahead and put the lands next to the deck of lands and the tokens anywhere up there. Next pack. Actually, I'm just going to show you just the way they are so you can see the artwork without me having to stop and read them. Interesting artwork, even if it doesn't focus. 4, 5. Oh, look at that one. Nice. 6. I'm telling you, this artwork is just nice. Academy Drake, huh? 7, 8, nine, and look at the art of this one. Nice. And who is the artist of this one? Grigorz Rutkowski. It's gotta be Russian. And I think that's 10. Commons. Okay. Artifact creature. Oh. I'm telling you, all through this thing, the artwork is just different. It's just nicer or something. Jason Felix is the artwork on this one. So there's one uncommon, there's two uncommons, and this is the way these are stacked. They are two uncommons, the rare, and then probably an uncommon underneath. Okay, so this is isolated chapel, one of those special lands. It's a rare. And since it's a land, we're definitely going to take a look at the artist as soon as it focuses. As soon as it focuses. I really hate this camera sometimes. There we go. Isolated chapel enters the battlefield tap unless you control a plains or a swamp. So it's one of those dual colors. And the artist is Richard Wright. So Richard Wright also did the Memorial to War Red. Okay. So that's an interesting note to make. Let's put the rare with the rare. Here's the other uncommon. We're just going to go ahead and put that with the uncommons without even mentioning it. And this is Dimitar's Marinsky's Plains. And a saproling token. Okay. Next. Let's see if I can speed this up. Well, I can't speed it up if I'm going to look at all the artists, though. So I'm trying not to look at as many. Deep freeze. One. Two. I mean, I'm sorry. I just... Look at the detail on that. I mean, it is cartoonish, but look at the... Come on, focus. Look at the detail. It will focus. Thank you very much. I mean, that's... Look at the background. You see there's more of the goblins in the background with their pickaxes? I mean, that's pretty cool.
All right, enough of that. So, one, two, three. It looks like I have a foil. I can see it in the background. Sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that's 9 commons before I get to the uncommon. Sentinel Merfolk Soldier. Okay. 1. Obviously, you see the foil glittering back there. I couldn't help myself there. 1, 2. And a rare is Tempest Dijin. Tempest Dijin. Dijin is a genie thing. Okay. And a foil, Elf Scout. And it's just a common.
Again, the artwork. And look at the way the foil makes the artwork look. Nice. Very nice. Okay, we gotta make room for foils now. So we'll put them next to the rares.
Okay. There's the legendary creature. By the way, I haven't been looking. I was told that there was a legendary creature. Like, oh, look at this. It's 8/8. It's a big one. This forest is... Marinsky's. So you can see it's the same there. Alright, so let's go put that there. A knight token. So the legendary creature here is Slim Voda Rising Deep or something like that. But I haven't been checking. These are the uncommons. I haven't been checking all of them. So let's see very quickly. Yeah, see, right away. It's legendary creature, artifact creature, legendary creature, okay? So, yeah. There's apparently a legendary creature in every pack. I'll make better note of it next time. Next pack. Let's go ahead and put these lands in the box. Make some room here. Okay. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Look at that fucking one. Oops, here's my fridge. Okay, it's not gonna focus, so I'm not gonna bother. 5, 6, 7, 8. Fungal infection for number 9. It's got a face, you see it? Target creature gets -1/-1 until end of turn. Create a 1/1 green strapple wing creature token. Nice. Alright. And 10 is a Pegasus Courser. Courser. Pegasus Courser. Interesting artwork. Alright. Commons. Fight with Fire and Shield of Realm are 2 uncommons. And I got an Elf Knight for the uncommon, or is that for the rare. Okay. It's a Steel Leaf Champion. Look at the teeth on that thing. And legendary creature. It's an uncommon legendary creature, and I think I saw this in one of the videos I was watching. This might be worth a couple of pennies. Can't be target of abilities your opponent controls, or your opponent's control. She gets +1/+1 for each creature you control. It costs 2 mana, 1 green, 1 white, and so a good time to play this would be if you got a whole mess of creatures out there. And so you got 4 or 5 creatures out there. You can get like a 5/5, a 4/4. Not bad. Not bad card at all. So it's an uncommon legendary creature. And the mountain is Tidus Lunters. I'm just going to drop that right in the box. And the token. You know what? I'm going to drop these tokens in the box too. Let's make some room here. That'd be better. Moving right along. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 left. And this is, this will be number 5, another one. There would be 5 left after this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Corrosive Ooze. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, look at that. Nice. 8, 9, and 10. And those are the commons. That's the wall again. Okay. And that's an uncommon. And the Weight of Memory. And I got a rare. Now this is a new card. Let me just. There's a new type of card, or perhaps they brought back. I think there was a set that had something like this in it before. I'm not sure if it was this card or if these types of cards. They're called sagas. I think it's a new idea. And I remember looking through some of these on the price lookup. I think this particular one may actually be worth a few dollars. I'm not positive, but I just seem to remember the rare saga being worth a few dollars. Destroy all lands. And 2 is each player returns 2 land cards from their graveyard to their battlefield. To the battlefield. Okay. Not bad. I love this artwork too. It's a whole different, you know, I like the setup of the way this card looks. Like a document almost, you know, with a picture on it. Okay, so that's my rare. And here's the legendary creature. So yes, the person who commented, I don't remember his name, is correct. There seems to be a legendary creature in every pack. Okay, so that's a cool thing. All right, we'll just go ahead and put that on here in comments. And the swamp is Lunter's, Titus Lunter's. Okay, we'll go ahead and just drop that in the box and drop that in the box. Okay, number six. Moving right along. Bloodstone Goblin. 1, 2. Oh, look at that. Artificer's Assistant. Nice, huh? It's a bird, obviously. It's got flying, obviously. It's only got a 1/1, but whenever you cast a historic spell, scry one. Yeah, it's a new mechanic that I gotta learn now. I didn't even learn the other ones from the days gone by. All right, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sorry, I wasn't showing it on the camera. 8. Look at this thing. Gigantor. 9 and 10. And we have another saga. This one is just an uncommon. Triumph of Gerard. Common is a Orc Warrior. My rare. Oh, I got a rare land. Hinterland Harbor. I bet you this is worth a penny or two. Hinterland Harbor enters the battlefield tapped. Unless you control a forest or an island. And it looks like Daniel Leumgren is the artist on this one. Very nice, very nice. And what do we have here? The legendary creature is Rona, disciple of Jix or Gix, I'm not sure which. An uncommon. All right. The island is Dimitar's Marinsky's. Okay, and it's open. All right. I can see right away we got another one of those birds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Ooh, I got a Wizard's Lightning. I've seen this card talked about. Nice. I like the artwork too, and the artwork is from the Russian guy, Grizzard. Grzegorz Rutowski. Jeez Christ, I can't even speak anymore, especially when I'm trying to do Russian. Interesting stuff. Okay, that's an uncommon. And Settle the Score is a sorcery uncommon. Oh, wait, what do we have here? We have 3 uncommons in a row. There's something up with this deck. I might have something special. I might have something special. So the third uncommon, without being separated by the rare, is on Sierra's Wings. Or Sarah's Wings. Sorry, Sarah's Wings. It's a legendary enchantment. And it will focus. Says me. Dang nabbit. Are you kidding me? Blackout time. There we go. Alright. So that's an uncommon as well. Now, what do we have underneath? I'm just teasing. Nabon, Dean of Iteration. Is it rare? And what's underneath? Dun-dun-dun-dun. Nothing. I don't get it. Oh, that's the legendary creature. Oh, so maybe because it's a rare legendary creature? Instead of just being a legendary creature in common or whatever? That's a possibility. Okay, we're just going to put the land in there. I'm not going to tell you who the artist is. I think that's the way it's working. So, if it's a legendary creature that's rare, let's find out. Is there any other legendary creatures in this rare pile? No, there is not. So, if it's a rare legendary creature, you don't get the... Well, you get the three... You don't get the other rare or something like that. That's pretty weird. Okay. All right. We'll figure out this sooner or later. And this one doesn't want to open. That means there's something special in this one. Because I said so. Okay. Give me a mythic. Come on. I got three packs. This one and two others. I want a mythic. One, two, three. Whoa. What the hell is that? Again, with the artwork. I'm telling you, this artwork is definitely... excuse me. The artist's name is Darken. Or is it Da Arken? It's Da Arken, I think. That's crazy. Nice work. Nice artwork. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... Navigator's Compass, I think it's worth a few pennies too. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Lingering Phantom is my first uncommon. Joyra's Familiar is my second uncommon.
Look at that. Owl wearing glasses or something. Actually, that's exactly what it is. Oh, I don't know if it's glasses or something else.
Okay. And there's another one. Third uncommon in a row. So, I'm guessing that the legendary creature is a rare. And it is. It's a vampire named Kazarov Zengir Pureblood. Igor. Of course, it's Igor. Whatever, I can't pronounce his last name.
Okay, so it's a legendary, rare legendary creature.
So it looks like that's the way it actually works. The forest is Mark Pools, and I got a soldier token. Two more packs. This is one of them. Come on, mythic. Or maybe there is no mythics in this set. That'd be weird. One fire elemental. Look at this. Flame on. Two. Three. Four. Excuse me. Five. Six. 7, 8, 9, and 10. And our first uncommon is one of those sagas called Chainer's Torment.
And of course it's black. Look at the artwork on that. Counter, sacrifice three after three. I don't know what that means. It's another mechanic that I don't know about.
Okay. I'm getting stuffed up or something. I don't know why. I got the Sorcerer's Wand. And what else? And, oh, I thought for a second I thought it was a mythic. A Human Knight.
This is my rare. Okay.
And the legendary creature is just an uncommon. It's Tetsuko Ubazawa Fugitive.
He doesn't look too healthy. Or she? He? I don't know. Human Rogue.
And a mountain and a construct token. Okay, one more pack. No mythics out of all of them, but I did get a rare legendary creature. Okay, another one of those goblins. One, two, oh, I just unburied a foil. Three, four, five, six, see it?
See it glistening in the back there?
Where was I? 6, 7, 8, 9. It's only 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Something special about this pack, besides the fact that I got a foil. Song of Freylice is an uncommon saga. I like it. It's green.
I like it. I like the artwork on these.
Knight of Malice is the next uncommon. And Board of Weatherlight is the third uncommon. And that's not separated by a rare. Oh, I got a foil saga, the Chainer's Torment that I got on the other one. Wow, I bet you this is worth a few pennies. So let's compare them.
Nice, huh?
Nice. Foil pile. Here we go. Oh, I did get a mythic.
Legendary creature, Elemental Avatar. Miltani Yavimaya's Avatar. Oh, wow. I think this card is probably worth more than a few pennies.
We're going to have to get a sleeve on that one right away. Let's put that in sight. And we got Dimitar Marinsky's
Swamp. Why doesn't that look familiar? I don't know why.
Okay. Wow. Last pack, we come up with that card. I wish that I could trust this thing not to shut off, you know, the recording software, not to shut off if I tried to go on the web to look up the price of that card for you. Because the last time I tried it, it did that. So, I'll just have to tell you to look it up, and I'm going to look it up after we stop this. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the opening of my first Dominaria bundle pack. And please subscribe. Comments welcome. thank you to that one person who I can't remember the name who commented that I should realize that the legendary creatures come in every pack. So there you have it. Thanks again.